We shall now talk about scope of variables. So we'll go back to our old function, which was a failed swap, okay, which is shown here. So it is not returning any values. It is having two parameters of the type integer. And here it is declaring a local variable called as temp. So what happens is, in this main, when I call swap a comma b, when the control comes here, this variable called temp is allocated space, all right? And the minute this flower brace is encountered, all the space allocated for temp is destroyed. So if you try to print the value of temp here, or if you try to say percentage d temp, you're going to get a compile time error. So variables which are declared here, like int temp, I could have had int ij. These are all known as local variables, and they are automatically allocated when this function code begins to just execute. Once this flower brace is reached, it is deallocated. Then the important word called as scope. I can print the value of temp starting from its declaration all the way till this brace. If I try to print the value of temp or xy here, I am going to get a compiler error, because temp x and y have life only within this flower bracket. They have no existence or no access outside this flower brace. That's why their scope is limited to this flower bracket. So x and y, similar to temp, have only scope within this particular flower bracket. So these variables like temp xy are called as, sorry, not xy, temp is called as an auto or automatic local variable type, because once the function is called, data is space is allocated for this, and once the function exits, space allocated for that is deallocated. So I hope this clarifies your idea about what is a automatic variable. For example, all these a b here are also examples of automatic local variables. You are not required to use the word auto int. Auto is assumed by default. Only if you want a different type, then you are going to mention that keyword. So these are all variables which get created when main is first called. The minute this bracket is reached, these will get destroyed, or space allocated for that is going to get deleted. Now, what we shall do is, we shall try to take a look at the next type of variable and try to understand what it really means. So the next type of variable is known as the static variable, or the, we are going to talk about the static local variable. So what I have done is, I have created a function where I am saying int I is equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. And I am calling this static where concept function. And here also I have defined a variable static int I is equal to 0. You need to understand a few things very clearly here. The I declared here has a life only between this and this. This I is not the same as this static int I. This I will exist in a different memory location. This I will exist in a different memory location. So if you do anything to this, nothing is going to happen to this. Same, if you do anything to this, nothing is going to happen to this. Now, what this word static int I does is, you will know about the static keyword once we call this function and try to get the output. So what I do is, I is 0. 0 is less than 5, so I am calling this function static where concept. When I call this function, I is going to be initialized to 0. Then I am printing the value of I. I is going to print as 0. After printing, I value becomes 1. I am talking about this I here, not this I. I becomes 1. Now I come back here. Here, this I has increased by 1, it becomes 1. 1 is less than 5. Again, I call this flow. Now what happens is, this I value will not get reinitialized back to 0. Because of this static keyword, I will retain its previous value, what it was during the last function call. Since during the last function call, 0 became 1, the current value of I is going to be 1. Since it is 1, now it is going to print 1 here, and this I here is going to become 2. Now I am going to come back here. I is now 2 here. This I is different from this I. This I is also 2. 2 is less than 5. Now when I come back here, I will get the old value. From 0 it had become 1, 1, 1 it had become 2. So it will print 2 and increase I by 1. So with the static keyword, the old value of the variable is retained, whatever was the value during the previous function call. That is one important aspect. The next important aspect is, this storage for this I, static int I, is allocated for the entire duration of the program. Automatic variables were created when the function was called and destroyed when the function exited. But here, once they are created at the beginning of the program, they will remain in existence till the end of the program. Now, it retains the prior value. I had already told you about I returning the old value when you keep calling it. Next is, the scope of this I is only between this particular bracket. In place of I had said say j, and I had made this as j++. If I had tried to print j here, I would have got a compile time error. So I hope you understand what is a local static variable. Now what we shall do is, we shall try to understand through a program what exactly we mean by external variables and what are the drawbacks or pitfalls that we need to avoid when using external variables. So first take a look at this concept code of external variables. Now I have a function called as showMessage, where in that message I am trying to print the message India, okay, after a space. I have a function called as main. In main, I have declared a variable. I have taken a variable I is equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus. Same here, for I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus. But this time what different I have done is, I have declared I outside any of the function. That means this is a global variable. This value of I can be accessed here, it can be accessed here. The I am referring here is this I. The I am referring here is this I. So if I change the value of I here, it will also affect here. Or if I change the value of I here, it will also affect here. So let's try to understand the program. Initially I is 0. So what I am doing is, I am calling I is equal to 0, I less than 3, the function show message. 0. 0 is less than 3. So I am going here, and again I am giving the initial value of I is 0. Till I becomes 3, I am printing India, India, India 3 times. At some point I will become 3. The first time it prints, I becomes 1. Second time it prints, I becomes 2. Third time it prints, I becomes 3. Now 3 is not less than 3. So it will fail and it will come back here. Now when I come back here, I has already become 3. So 3 is less than 3 becomes false. So rather than it printing India, India 9 times based on this logic, it is only going to print India, India 3 times. Because you change the value of I, it not only got affected here, it also got affected here, because the I happened to be a global variable. So variables declared outside all functions are global variables. Global variables are used for communicating values between different functions without doing any passing of arguments. So I was able to use I here and here without doing any passing. Global variables are useful when you have very few global variables and a large number of functions using them, or you have the other way around, or you have a large number of variables which are used by a small set of functions. This is very important to understand. It is best avoided to use global variables because of the problems like this. I was expecting it to print 9 times, it only printed 3 because the I was getting affected in this place and affecting here also. So you are better off using parameters to pass values. Here, as I showed you, without knowledge, you may accidentally modify the value. Suppose I have written a program using global variables and thousands of functions. Suppose I accidentally modify the value of a global variable. To find out in which function I modified the value of the global variable is going to be extremely difficult. So please avoid using global variables as far as possible. Another drawback of global variable is it becomes difficult for the code to be reused, because that code will not work if that global variable is not declared in that place thing. Last but not the least, give long meaningful names to global variables and short meaningful names to local variables.